You can do so many things within the world of STEM that I don't think people know about. Many people find it daunting enough that they don't necessarily dare try to have a grasp on it. If you visualize data in the right way, not only is it beautiful to look at, interesting to explore, but it can draw readers in. My name is Lee Buli, and I am a data journalist. I think STEM encompasses so much more in our modern society than people realize. My background is in magazine journalism. I'm a writer and journalist first and foremost. And then I became very interested in the space of big data as my beat, and then ended up starting to work with this information to write articles.
Lee and I met in June 2012 when I started working at Next Big Sound. Lee was the data journalist there, and before I started, she was the one woman at a company of 20 other men.
When I first heard about Next Big Sound, which was this small startup, three young guys who had started a company to predict who was going to be the next big Beyonce or Lady Gaga, just that idea was so interesting to me that you could use math, statistics, numbers, and data, STEM, to be able to identify something that was such a creative aesthetic pursuit. I started to be able to figure out who was going to be the next big artist long before these people were ever on the radio or ever became a household name, just by looking at the numbers and looking at their trajectory and looking what was going on with the data behind them. Creating beautiful, simple, readable graphs that people can easily connect with can often be a great way to convey a story. And it can make your audience more excited about what you're doing, and it can also make them comprehend something far easier than if they're looking at a giant spreadsheet full of numbers where the interesting story doesn't necessarily pop out at you. We're not necessarily motivating kids at an early enough age to get involved and pursue this career. No one said to me when I was a kid, hey, you know, there's a bunch of different things that you could do that are creative applications of science, technology, engineering, and math to STEM. If we teach kids that early on and get them excited about it, they'll get involved. VizKids is a series of books about data visualization for kids.
What I understand about VizKids is it came out of Lee being the data journalist at Next Big Sound and taking courses in data science and data journalism and realizing the lack of education on this topic for children.
Educating kids early on, getting them excited about what possible applications are and allowing them to explore, that I think is incredibly important. That means that 20 years down the line, we're going to have people involved in STEM that are from all walks of life. And that's when we get to the differing perspectives that help us get to the best ideas.
Lee is very impressive. As she developed in her own career and saw what she wanted to do and what she wanted to write about, she set herself on a path to accomplish it.
Don't ever let anybody tell you no, that something can't be done or that you can't create something. If you have a goal, go after it and you can make it happen. I think the louder and prouder girls are about their jobs in STEM and the amazing stuff they're doing, the more we can teach people, look, these are all the amazing things you can do. And it doesn't necessarily mean that you have to be a software engineer. That's when we're really gonna inspire young girls to come join.